But we begin with the new and completely modern, a fusion of modern music, modern dance, and modern technology. Relying on exotic audio equipment, three local musicians, Carl Weingarten, Dave Udell, and Walter Whitney, have combined their talents and formed a musical group called Delay Tactics. They record under the label Multiphase, and as you'll see, it's an apt description of their work.
At first, the sound seemed otherworldly, something Ron Serling might have forecast years ago. But this isn't a story from the Twilight Zone. Even though the audio synthesizer is a member of the band. This is about a new type of musician, high-tech recording artists, whose melodies are the electronic signal, whose compositions are off the cuff, whose performances are on miles and miles of recording tape, and whose music has been so well received that this trio, Delay Tactics they're called, has recorded soundtracks for some of the top modern dancers in the Midwest.
As a choreographer, it's very stimulating. I hear their music visually, if that makes sense. Or I when I hear their music, I will see movement and images and get a lot of ideas for choreography.
Special effects shape the production as well as the performance of the music. From start to finish, the new technology lends a creative hand.
In the process of working in the studio, I'll get different ideas and I'll just throw different things on it to see how it fits. Or I'll do crazy things, running stuff on the tape backwards. I do that a lot. Some sounds, reversed, sound much nicer to me than going normal.
What would a slight modulation be like in the delay?
These musicians are not performers by profession, nor do they plan to have the popularity they're having now. They began just as three guys, Dave, Walt, and Carl, hamming and jamming with the equipment in Walt's basement, composing for the fun of it, for the fun and the feel of it.
We're not really a performing band as the type of working every week and being out in the clubs or anything like that. Or even in terms of a concert. Being a performing band and being a studio unit is two totally different things. I mean, people think you form a band, you automatically know how to do both, and it's just not the same. And we're very good in the, working in the studio. But playing out live, we don't have all the elaborate equipment or the organization.
So, collaborating late into many nights, Delay Tactics compose their songs like a crazy quilt, patching chords and melodies upon strands of sounds they've already recorded, while the audio effects color their musical experiments.
Okay, just make some insect noises now, and we're good. People will think we meant to do that.
I don't try and take myself too seriously ever as a composer. I don't think I'm doing. I think if I take myself seriously as a composer, is the day I'll probably stop working and doing anything that's any good.
Carl Weingarten takes the music seriously. Not only lending it to dancers, he has organized his own recording company. And taking Delay Tactics tape to a record pressing plant just outside St. Louis, Weingarten has produced the group's first release, an album titled Any Questions? And so the sonic beat goes on. Even as each record's pressed, it's almost like a dance. Tactics melodies start from particles of sound. So too, the record starts from particles of ground vinyl. sculpted and molded into music. Plastic is transformed into a permanent concert of delayed tactics work. Sleeved and dressed into an album. Ready to be heard. Finally, the recorded signal is reshaped into the dance. Into movements reacting to the sounds. Amplifying the electronic experiments of experience.
Sell it as an industrial.
We get an offer in that direction, I'm sure we'll listen to it.
If we slow it down, it could be something that was more quiet.
We could speed it up.
We could speed it up and it'd
be a McDonald's.
Right.
Yeah. Anything.
I love the way we get six or seven or eight songs out of each recording we do.
Get the Johnny Mann singers to add something, you'll have a Chevy come for sure.
Carl Weingarten is now in the process of making a new release, Pandora's Garage, which you can look for sometime this spring.